हेलो, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर के डब्ल्यू पवार फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, रयत शिक्षण संस्था राव बहादुर नारायणराव बोराव के कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर डिस्ट्रिक्ट अहमदनगर। फ्रेंड्स, इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी द पर्टिकुलर ग्रोथ और व्हाट वी कॉल्ड द प्लांट ग्रोथ। द टॉपिक इज फ्रॉम फर्स्ट ईयर बीएससी, देर इज अ पेपर, बॉटनी पेपर सेकंड, बीओ 1-2, प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ प्लांट साइंस। हियर इन क्रेडिट फर्स्ट देर इज प्लांट फिजियोलॉजी एंड सेल बायोलॉजी। सो हियर देर इज प्लांट ग्रोथ एंड ग्रोथ रेगुलेटर्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द ग्रोथ, हाउ द ग्रोथ आर आकर, इंट्रोडक्शन, देन व्हाट इज द एक्चुअल डेफिनेशन ऑफ द ग्रोथ, देन व्हाट आर द स्टेजेस ऑफ द ग्रोथ और व्हाट आर द फेजेस ऑफ द ग्रोथ। एज वी नो दैट ग्रोथ इज द एसेंशियल कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ ऑल लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म। डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एंटायर ऑर्गेनिज्म सीन्स फ्रॉम द सिंगल सेल और व्हाट वी द इन टू द हायर प्लांट, सीन्स फ्रॉम द सिंगल सेल टू द हायर प्लांट और व्हाट वी कॉल्ड मैच्योर प्लांट फ्रॉम अ टीनी सीड्स इज सेट टू बी अ ग्रोथ। मीन्स व्हाट, सिंगल सेल टू अगेन मैच्योर प्लांट फ्रॉम द पर्टिकुलर स्मॉल सीड्स और टाइनी सीड्स एंड व्हाट वी कॉल्ड इट एज द पर्टिकुलर ग्रोथ। देर इज एन इंक्रीजिंग इन साइज, what we called growth, there is an increasing in size, shape, weight, height, length, biomass due to the particular growth. When the such parameters get increases, length, height, weight, biomass, then there is the shape and size, then one can called it as the particular growth takes place. It is a permanent and irreversible changes in an organism. The growth is the permanent change or what we call permanent and irreversible change in organism. Growth occurs due to the cell enlargement and cell division. As we know that there is the particular cell division and due to this cell division there is the particular growth occur. It involves various physiological and biochemical process. During the growth there is the different physiological and biochemical processes that are involved. It needs favorable external and internal environmental conditions or what we called external and internal factors that are responsible for the particular growth. One of the internal factor that is the growth regulators or regulate the growth, that is the plant growth regulators. These particular factors regulate the particular growth in plants or what we called, oftenly we called it as the plant growth regulator. The sum of the total, sum of the total of growth and differentiation is called as the development in case of the particular plant. So plant growth is different from the animal. Here growth, because like animal, plant retain the capacity. What is the difference? A plant retain the capacity for unlimited growth throughout their life cycle. For example, there is the particular perennial trees. Throughout the life cycle, plant retain their growth, but this uniqueness is due to the presence of meristem at a certain location in the particular plant body, or there is the presence of meristem in the at the certain location in the plant body. At this meristem, rapid mitosis is occurred, or due to the rapid mitosis, it provide the particular new cells, which soon lost the capacity of divide and differentiated to provide the particular new tissue. So it is different from the particular animal in case of the particular plant. Here one can define what is the growth. Growth can be defined as the permanent and irreversible increase in an organism. There is the irreversible, this is the important, permanent. These two things are important here. One is the permanent and another one is the irreversible. Permanent irreversible increases in an organism, and what we call it as the growth. Or otherwise, we can define growth. Growth is the vital process which bring about a permanent change. Okay, so it is the vital process that bring about the permanent change in any organism or its part. In organism or its part, okay, with respect to its size, weight, volume. With respect to size, weight, volume, so it is vital process which bring about the particular permanent changes in organism or its part with respect to the particular size, weight and volume. So this is the definition of the growth. Then phases of growth. Okay, phases of growth. Here there is the development is the gradual increase in size. When there is the development is occurred, that is the gradual increase in size. Development is the process where there is the where there is the ordered change progressed. What happened? There is ordered change progress towards the higher and more complex form. When there is a development takes place, there is the ordered change from higher to the more complex form. The development also defined as process in which growth, differentiation, maturation and senescence takes place in a regular sequence of the life history of the particular plant. So in plants, growth is confined with only to the particular meristem. So during the process of growth, during the it is not immediate phenomenon. Growth is not immediate phenomenon. It is a continuous marching of plant in orderly manner. So there are the particular, during the process of growth, meristematic cell have to pass the three phases. Number one, there is the cell formation, meristematic cells have passed under the three phases, cell formation or what we call cell division phase. Okay, then second one is that there is the cell enlargement, cell enlargement or what we called cell elongation phase. And third thing is that there is the particular cell differentiation. Cell differentiation, or it is called as maturation, cell maturation phase. So here the meristematic cells have passed through the three different phases, or what we called the cell formation, or it is also called as the phases of the growth. So we can see one by one, that is the phases of growth. Cell formation, cell enlargement and cell differentiation. First of all, there is the particular cell formation. It is the first phase. Okay, cell formation is the first phase. ऑफ ग्रोथ इन विच व्हाट हैपन हियर इन केस ऑफ द नेम इटसेल्फ इंडिकेट दैट देयर इज द पर्टिकुलर सेल फॉर्मेशन और सेल डिवीजन इज हियर. सो हियर इन विच आफ्टर सेल डिवीजन न्यू सेल्स आर फॉर्म्ड. आफ्टर सेल डिवीजन न्यू सेल्स आर फॉर्म्ड. ओके, सो आफ्टर सेल डिवीजन देयर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द न्यू सेल. दिस सेल्स आर स्मॉल इन साइज. बेसिकली व्हाट हैपन, दिस सेल्स इज ऑफ स्मॉल इन साइज, हैव एन एक्टिव न्यूक्लियस एंड साइटोप्लाज्म. स्मॉल साइज, एक्टिव न्यूक्लियस एंड साइटोप्लाज्म. ओके, फर्स्ट फेज सेल फॉर्मेशन और सेल डिवीजन. देयर इज द हियर आफ्टर सेल डिवीजन देयर इज द न्यू सेल्स आर फॉर्म्ड एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर सेल्स हैव द स्मॉल साइज. देन देयर इज द एक्टिव न्यूक्लियस एंड साइटोप्लाज्म इज प्रेजेंट. दे आर रेडी टू एब्सॉर्ब वाटर एंड फूड मटेरियल. रेडी टू एब्सॉर्ब वाटर एंड फूड मटेरियल. नाउ सेल आर रेडी टू एब्सॉर्ब वाटर एंड फूड मटेरियल एंड हैव हाई मेटाबोलिक रेट. अगेन इट हैज हाई मेटाबोलिक रेट. ओके, सो हियर देयर इज अ हाई मेटाबोलिक रेट. देन सेल वॉल आर थिन एंड सेल कंटेन लार्ज क्वांटिटी ऑफ सोल्यूट. सेल वॉल थिन एंड सेल कंटेन लार्ज क्वांटिटी ऑफ सोल्यूट. ओके, सो दिस मच थिंग दैट इज ऑकर्ड इन द पर्टिकुलर सेल फॉर्मेशन और सेल डिवीजन फेज. हियर दिस इज द फर्स्ट फेज ऑफ ग्रोथ. आफ्टर सेल डिवीजन देयर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द न्यू सेल टेक्स प्लेस. दैट पर्टिकुलर न्यू सेल्स आर दे आर द स्मॉल साइज, एक्टिव एंड हैव द एक्टिव न्यूक्लियस एंड साइटोप्लाज्म इज देयर. And they are now ready to absorb the water and food material, and they have the high metabolic rate. Cell walls that are thin and cell contain large quantity of the particular solute. Okay, so this much is happen in the particular cell formation phase, or what we call it as the cell division phase. Now second phase is of what? There is the cell enlargement. Cell enlargement, or what we call cell elongation. Elongation phase. Cell enlargement, here again word itself indicate that there is the enlargement of cell or elongation of the cell. After accumulation of large quantity of solute, after accumulation of large quantity of solute, what will happen? After accumulation of large quantity of solutes, the cell absorb water by osmotic process. Cells absorb the water. Absorb water by osmotic process. okay, which result, what is the result? Cells absorb the water by the osmotic process. Here there are the different osmotic processes are there, which result in increases in the turgidity. Increase turgidity, which result into the particular increases into the turgidity of the cell, and expansion of the elastic cell wall takes place. Expansion of cell wall takes place, okay, or what we call expansion of the elastic cell wall takes place, and this result into increases in the volume of the cell. Here increases turgidity, then due to the increases in turgidity, there is the expansion of cell wall takes place, and as a result of this, increasing the volume of cells. Increasing the volume of cell due to the expansion of elastic cell wall, increasing the volume of the cell. More cellulosic molecule get deposited on the cell wall, due to which more water is absorbed. More cellulosic molecule get deposited into the cell wall, and due to which more water is absorbed and cell become fully turgid, or what we call cell is now turgid in condition. Turgidity increases due to the appearance of the large central vacuole in the cell. Why there is the turgidity increases? Because there is the appearance of the large vacuole in the cell, and it leads into the increases in the length, size, length and size of cell. Okay, so this is the reason, due to the increases in the turgidity, appearance of large central vacuole in each cell, and it leads to increases in the length and size of the particular cell. Okay, so this much thing is happen in second phase, that is cell enlargement phase. Third phase is that cell, third and last phase, that is what? Cell differentiation. Differentiation, or what we call cell maturation phase. Okay, cell differentiation. Now after the elongation or after the enlargement, there is the particular differentiation and maturation phase. Here in this phase, metabolic activities of the particular cell increases. Metabolic activity of cell increases. Metabolic activity of cell increases, and now the cell accumulate food material. Due to the metabolic activity of cell, increasing metabolic activity, there is the cell accumulate the food material, and secondary cell wall are laid down. Here what happen? Secondary cell wall laid down. Okay, so secondary cell wall laid down, and cell mature and get differentiated into the tissues. Okay, here now cell mature and get differentiated into the particular tissue, there is a no change in the size of the cell. Now there is no change in the size of the cell, means what we call, this is the mature cell or different, it is particular differentiated into tissue, and after that there is no change in the particular cell or size of cell. Many biochemical changes occur in the cell and cell entered into the senescence phase. Okay, after that many biochemical changes that are occur into the cell and cell enters into the senescence phase. So this much is happen in the particular cell differentiation or maturation phase. Growth phase can be clearly seen, phases of growth you can clearly seen in the particular germinating seed. Okay, then grand period of growth, what is called grand period of growth? Grand period of growth means what? It is the course of growth of the plant. Course of growth of the plant. Okay. Course of growth of the plant. Here what happened? Growth is slow at beginning. Growth is slow at beginning. Or what we call at cell formation phase, it become rapid later at cell elongation phase, and again slow down at the cell maturation phase, as we see, and attains a steady stage. After that there is the attains of the steady stage. If a graph is plotted by considering the growth against the particular time, suppose there is the growth against the times, then it result into the S-shaped curve. It result into the S-shaped curve known as sigmoid curve. Sigmoid curve. Here you can see there is the S-shaped curve. Here this is the lag phase, log phase. Okay, this one is the lag phase, log phase, and third one stationary phase. Okay. When we plot the graph here, there is the days, whatever the, and here there is the area of the particular leaf. Area of leaf in particular centimeter, square centimeter. Okay, so area of leaf in square centimeter, suppose whatever it may be, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, so on up. Okay, and days, how many days? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, so on up to. Okay, so when we plot such a type of the graph and we get the S-shaped curve, this one is the S-shaped curve, and what we called it as the sigmoid curve. Growth began in an organism, it is continued until organism acquired permanent form. Total period required by organism to grow, what is the grand period of growth? What one can define the grand period of growth? Total period required by organism to grow and acquire a permanent form means what? Total period is required for growth and acquire the permanent form is known as the grand period of the particular growth. And the term first time used by the German physiologist Sachs in the year 1873. So this is the particular grand period of the growth. So this is about the growth, phases of growth and grand period of growth. Okay, thank you.